Hello everyone, welcome back to Power Solar Creation video tutorial. In this video, you are going to look at smart objects and rasterize. So you are going to look at the difference between smart object and not a smart object. Please make sure that you check your source file, download the image and follow along. It's going to be in the description below. You check it and download and you can follow along. So with this image selected, I'll open it in Photoshop, drag, then leave it in Photoshop and click on enter or return on the mark, and you see that when you drop it, and you see that there is a little mark here showing that this is what a smart object and what not a smart object. You will not see anything like that. So with smart object, we can scale this image down, and click on enter, and we can scale it up very large, and you see that we haven't lost any detail. Okay, so let's try this image without being a smart object. So right click on the layer, click on duplicate layer. Okay, this image is also a smart object, so to make it a smart object, right click and choose rasterize layer, and notice something. You see that the small box here has gone away because this image is not a smart object. All right, so let's try and see the difference. So I'll hold both of the layers 1 and 2 and scale it down, hit enter on my keyboard or return on the Mac, and with both layers selected, I will scale them up, hold drag, and hit enter or return on the Mac, and you can testify from here that one of them pixelated. That means one of them lost quality whilst increasing, so you can see the difference. This is the smart object, and this is the smart object, and this is not a smart object. So you see that this one is not a smart object compared to the smart object. So you see the difference. In order to maintain the quality of your images and stuff in Photoshop, make sure that you always turn them to a smart object. Even if it is not a smart object, maybe let me delete this one. Even if I right click and click on rasterize layer, and the layer is not a smart object, so let me reduce the size so that you can verify. Then I will increase it again. You see that the picture start to lose quality. Let me reduce it again, enter, increase it, and you see that it start to lose quality. Last one, increase it again, and you see that the picture start to lose quality. So if undo, so even if your image is not a smart object, you can right click and you can just convert to a smart object. So when you scale it down, hit enter, then scale it up again, and it sees that your image is cool without losing any quality. This means that when your image is a smart object, Photoshop is kind of protects the image. So when you even scale it down, it's try to keep the pixels so that the image will not lose quality. But if it is not a smart object, it loses quality. So let's try this example also. So go to your source file, check this image, drag it into Photoshop, and this one is a project that we did for our client, and I took a nice picture at that place. So with this image open, go to your source file and drag this logo into it, leave it, and click on enter or return on the mark, And you can see that anytime that you drag and drop image or a text or a logo into Photoshop, Photoshop is kind of convert it to a smart object, so that when you are working with it, it will not lose quality. So with the same technique, let me make it black and so that we can view it. So go to FX color, then turn it to black. So I will duplicate my layer, right click and say duplicate layer, click on OK. Then I will change the down one to rasterize. I'll rasterize the layer style, and then with both layers selected, I will reduce it down, hit enter. Then with the both layers selected again, I will increase it and hit enter. So you can see from here, select one from the other, you can see that the one with the smart object, this one didn't lose quality, but the other one without smart objects lost its quality. So this is a way to protect your images and your logo so that they won't lose quality. All right, let's try one more example. Go to your source file and make sure that this image is open. Move it to Photoshop and you can see a nice gentleman. That's my boss who taught me Photoshop. I really appreciate him and I love him so much. Both of us, me and him, bear the same name, Solomon. My boss, I salute. So with this image selected, you can go to any of the other software of Photoshop. Like maybe you don't have any knowledge in Adobe Illustrator, but don't worry, as time goes on, you comment below if you want to make some awesome logos and stuff and you want to learn. Let me know in the comment below that you are interested in learning how to design logos and stuff, and I'll start a video on Illustrator too. So with my Illustrator open, this is a logo that I did for my brand. Then I will drag this image into Photoshop and I will leave it. And you see that when I click on enter, Photoshop converts it to a smart object for me. Let me delete it and try again. Go to Illustrator. Then I'm going to copy the image. Then I'll come and paste it here. Paste, and you see that when you are pasting, Photoshop will give you option, do you want to add it to a smart object, pixels? And so let's first of all try a smart object. Click OK, go to edit again, hit enter, then go to edit again, paste. But this time around we are going to turn it into a non-smart object, that's pixels. Hit enter and you can drag this one away from the other one and hit enter to save changes. So you see that this is not a smart object and this is a smart object. So with both image selected, I just select the first one, I hold shift to select the other one, then I will increase the scale of both image, increase it, then I'll hit enter and I'll drag both in, drag this one in, select this one and drag that one also in. So when I zoom in, you can see that this one is pixelated a bit and this one is not pixelated even one bit. So always go for 100% smart objects. And we have some drawbacks to smart objects, like if I want to apply healing brush tool to this, you see that I cannot apply it to a smart object. When I try, Photoshop, you said this smart object must be rasterized before proceeding. So if I click on OK, the image turned from smart object to become a normal image, and the image is not protected anymore. That's one of the drawbacks. Maybe when it undo, that's Control Z. So maybe I want to apply some filter to this smart object image, and I go to filters, blur, and you see that lens blur cannot be applied to a smart object. But when I try it with a non-smart object blur, and you can see that lens blur can be applied to. So we have a little drawbacks or disadvantage, but still smart object is the best way, unless you are doing something that it does not support smart object, then you go for the other way around. So let me delete. Okay, so one more example. If I go to with this one with a smart object, I can double click on it, I can open it, and you see that it will open in the software that I design the original work, or I design the logo, and it is not going to open on the original image. So it will open it in a different page or a different document for you. So you can make changes. Maybe I don't want this part. Ungroup, and maybe I don't want this part, I delete this one, and maybe I add some changes to it, hit OK, then I save it. So when I go to Photoshop, I expect that Photoshop should make changes to that effect for me. You see that the name didn't come, and the effect that I apply here just did it for me. And with the other image, which is not a smart object, you cannot open it. In when I try to open it, you see that it is only effect that I can apply on it, but smart object can go, it can take you to the original software that you design your work, and you make changes and it will just appear. So let me make one last change. Maybe I'll change the background to something like green, then I'll click on save. Go to Photoshop, let me save it again. I'll click on save. Go to Photoshop, and you see that the changes just appeared in Photoshop. So these are the reasons why we use smart object, and smart object are the best. So always make sure you are 100% on smart objects when you are designing. Alright, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe if you haven't yet. Like, share this video. Comment below your suggestions and anything that you want to draw my attention on. I will be really appreciated if these things come. And please make sure to watch the previous tutorial if you haven't. This is episode 14 out of 1 up to the 14. So if you haven't watched those videos, go back and watch them. It's a beginner tutorial, and it's going to help you to start from the beginning. Maybe you've opened Photoshop before and you struggle with it. These are the videos that are going to help you to lift you from the bottom all the way to a professional design. So please make sure to watch them, make sure to share the videos, share the link, copy the link, share to your friend who want to learn. And please, with these tips, you are going to do an amazing things in Photoshop. Thank you for watching this video. Bye for now.